everybody.
No, fine. Okay. Today we study with the themes atlas of anatomy. We are study part of the head and neuro anatomy. In this part, in head part, we have many things to study: cranial bone, muscles of head, cranial nerve, topographical anatomy, oral cavities, nose, eyes orbit, and ear vestibular aperture, saxon anatomy of head. In this class, only bones and sutures So see, this is the frontal bone, and this is the parietal bone, and this is the occipital bone. So frontal bone is situated on the front side, and here present is a coronal suture. Okay, so sphenoparietal suture, frontal suture. Now we start coronal suture, sphenoparietal suture, and squamous suture, and sphenofrontal suture. Okay, the sphenosquamous suture. Supraorbital foramen present of the superior margin of the orbit, and here you see sphenoid bone, greater wing present, ethmoid bone, it's a lacrimal bone, it's a nasal bone, infraorbital foramen, maxilla and mandible, cemental foramen, zygomatic bone, zygomatic arc, temporal bone, styloid process, temporal bone, mastoid process, temporal bone, squamous part, occipital bone, lambdoid suture. See here we are study about cranium part. So if we see left lateral view, this view was selected as an introduction of to the skull because it's display the greater number of the cranial bone indicated by different color in B. The individual bone and their silent feature as well as cranial and suture and aperture are displayed by the units. They follow the unit of review of principal feature, the lateral aspect of the skull. This chapter as a whole is intended to familiarize the reader with the name of the cranial bone before proceeding to finer anatomical detail and the relationship of the bone to the another. The teeth described is separate unit. So frontal bone is there present, frontal, parietal, occipital and temporal bone. And here cheek, their side present is zygomatic bone, lacrimal bone, nasal bone, ethmoid bone, sphenoid bone. It's a here greater wing present, which lesser wing not show outer side because greater wing show is outer side. So it's mandible. Here temporal bone, tympanic, temporal bone, petrous part, occipital bone. Lateral view of cranial bone. If left lateral view, the bone are shown in different color of demonstrated are clearly their extent and boundaries. So lateral view of cranial bone, left lateral view, we see in B part, this is B diagram and this is C diagram and there is D. So if B diagram we see, so the bones are shown in different color to demonstrate it more clearly their extent and boundaries. And then ossification of the cranial bone, left lateral view, the bone of the skull either developed directly from the mesenchymal connective tissue because intermembranous ossification, it's gray showing this picture because the two pictures only show blue and gray. So the bone of the skull either developed directly from the mesenchymal connective tissue, so it's intermembranous ossification gray. So guys, of a form of directly by the ossification of the cartilaginous model, and chondral ossification blue, elements derived from the intermembranous and endochondral ossifications, desmocranium, chondrocranium may fuse together to form a single bone. Example, the occipital bone, temporal bone and sphenoid bone. The clavicle is only tuberal bone because clavicle bone, let's say we are called in girls beauty collarbone, beauty bone, and boys in collarbone. that the undergoes membranous ossification. This explain why congenital defect of the intermembranous ossification affect both the skull and clavicle. This is a cladocranial dysostosis, and this we are show this diagram orange and gray. So see in this diagram. Bone of the neurocranium gray part of a neurocranium, okay, and orange is visocranium. So left lateral view, the skull form a bony capsule that encloses the brain and sensory organ, viscera of the head, and the greater size of the neurocranium relative to the visocranium facial skeleton is a typical primitive feature directly connected with the large primitive brain. Bones of the neurocranium and visocranium, see here we are differences. See, neurocranium is gray, visocranium is orange. So neurocranium is gray, so only which part include in neurocranium? So frontal bone, sphenoid bone excluded this pteridoid rhizoid process. Temporal bone, squamous part is petrous part. Parietal bone, endocipital bone and ethmoid bone. And ethmoid bone part includes cerebriform plate. Viscerocranium orange is nasal bone, lacrimal bone, ethmoid bone, excluding the cerebriform plate. Sphenoid bone is pterygoid process, maxilla, zygomatic bone, temporal bone, tympanic part, styloid process, mandible, femur, inferior surface, turbinate, platine bone, and hyoid bone. Means you see, facial bones are mainly included in viscerocranium part, and neurocranium part include all cranium area. See, what a difference of desmocranium and chondrocranium. So desmocranium like a neurocranium, little bit change, and chondrocranium is like a viscerocranium. So desmocranium is nasal bone, lacrimal bone, maxilla, mandible, zygomatic bone, frontal bone, parietal bone, and occipital bone, upper part of squamous, temporal bone, squamous part, tympanic part, palatine bone, and vomer. Chondrocranium is ethmoid bone, sphenoid bone, excluding the middle plate of styroid process, and temporal bone, pteroid and mastoid part, styroid process. Occipital bone exclude the upper part of squama, inferior nasal turbinate, hyoid bone. Then we see here skull, whole skull bone present, and we see this is a frontal bone. You see orbital surface of the vertebral incisor present, frontal incisor present, and supra orbital margin, and then nasal bone, then sphenoid bone, laser wing, ethmoid bone, perpendicular plate, this infraorbital margin, this middle nasal concha, this vomer, inferior nasal concha, interior spine. Then here is piriform nasal, anterior nasal aperture, the zygomatic bone, and this sphenoid bone, this orbit, this is temporal bone, sphenoid bone is greater wing, parietal bone is supraorbital foramen, infraorbital foramen, this is teeth part, and inside the mantle foramen, and present on the mandible bone. See anterior view of the skull, the boundary of the facial skeletal vesicocranium can be clearly appreciate in the view. The individual bone are shown in B part. The bony margin of anterior nasal aperture mark the start of respiratory tract in the skull. Nasal cavity like the orbit contains sensory organ, the olfactory mucosa. The paranasal sinus are shown schematically in C. Interior view of the skull also displayed the three clinically important opening through which sensory nerve pass to supply the face, supraorbital foramen, infraorbital foramen, and mantle foramen. See here frontal bone, nasal bone, middle nasal concha, inferior nasal concha, and mandible and parietal bone, sphenoid bone, greater wing, temporal bone, sphenoid bone, greater bone, sphenoid bone of greater wing show you to temporal side, and see you to temporal side and orbit side. So this is maxilla, and see this is B part is shown in the blue is a line. So this is the pilar, vertical zygomatic pilar, and this is frontonasal pilar, and this horizontal zygomatic pilar, vertical, frontonasal, and horizontal. These are pilars, and you see next picture. See there is frontonasal pilar and vertical zygomatic pilar, and this is horizontal zygomatic pilar. Now we find next we start principal line of force, blue in the facial skeletal, anterior view, lateral view. The pneumatized paranasal sinus have a mechanical counterpart in the thick and bony pillar of the facial skeletal, which practically bound the sinus. This pillar develop along the principal line of the force in respond to local mechanical stress, masticatory pressure. In visual term, the frame like construction of the facial skeleton may be likened to that of the frame house. The paranasal sinus will represent the room, while the pillar placed along major line of force represent the supporting column. Now we see here next diagram. See, it's a frontal sinus, it's ethmoid cell, and here sphenoid sinus and maxillary sinus and nasal cavity. So sinus, frontal, ethmoid, frontal, sphenoid, and maxillary, three sinus here present, you see properly, and ethmoid cell and nasal cavity also. So paranasal sinus, pneumatization lightens the bone. Anterior view, some of the bone of the facial skeleton are pneumatized. They contain air-filled cavity that reduce the total weight of bone. This cavity, called the paranasal sinus, communicate with the nasal cavity and like it are lined by ciliated respiratory epithelium. Inflammation of the paranasal sinus and associated complaining are very common because some of the pain of sinusitis is projection to skin overlying the sinus. It is helpful to know to projection of the sinus onto the surface of skull. Here you see, guys, what is this? Here theagram you see, first, second, third. So first is related to fracture line run across the maxilla. So let Ely Fort. Here Ely Fort classification of mid facial fracture. Frame line construction of facial skeletal lead to characterized pattern of fracture line in the mid facial region. First Ely Fort one is this fracture line is run across the maxilla and above the hard plate. A maxilla is separated from the upper facial skeletal, disrupting the integrity of maxilla sinus. Low transverse fracture. Second is Ely Fort. Second is this fracture line passes across the nasal root, ethmoid bone, maxilla, and zygomatic bone, creating a pyramid fracture that disrupts an integrity of the orbit. Third is the facial skeletal is separated from the base of the skull. The main fracture line passes through the orbit and the fracture may additionally involve ethmoid bone, frontal sinus, sphenoid sinus, and zygomatic sinus. Skull posterior view of cranial sutures in next video. Okay, thank you guys.